Professor Arif Pasha to formally invite the guests.
The organizations will fail, and I'm sure most of you are all reading the newspapers, where in which, you know, on a day-to-day basis we are, you know, hearing the news that organizations fail because people, you know, do not follow the morals and the ethics. A lot of examples are there. Recently, because of the recession in the US economy slowdown, you must have seen that more than 100 banks have been collapsed. One of the biggest bank in America, called Lehman Brothers, it's collapsed. Why? Because, you know, the people who are managing the organization have not followed the ethics. Similarly, the recent example in case of our own country, Satyam, for example, you know, the organization has collapsed because the very chairman of that particular organization, Mr. Raju, was involved in kind of immoral activities, wherein which he was creating about 12,000 dummy accounts and transferring the money, you know, in terms of crores of rupees from, you know, the business to the unknown accounts. Okay, finally it came to picture, and the organization to become, you know, successful at a faster rate, we forget our principles, we forget our ethics, and thereby start doing all, you know, certain activities which will definitely take us in a this depression. I would like not like to take much of the time because we have a very prominent speaker, Mr. Umar Shariff, who is a president of NAG, who has been a very prominent speaker, and I have in fact heard one of his lectures, and I am thankful that he has come today for our you know, lecture program to address all of you, to, you know, to address certain important issues that each one of us have to follow, you know, in terms of the principles in our life. So I wholeheartedly welcome him.
Alhamdulillah. Indeed, all praises be to God. I am sincerely privileged to be amongst a very good audience here, because I can see a bouquet of beautiful faces. You know, how the bouquet is, you can see, you know, some white flowers, some yellow flowers, some red and some greenery, and it's packed beautifully and it's given. And I feel it the same way. I see a lot of people coming from various ethnicity or various cultures, various nations and lands, and I see you all put together as a beautiful bouquet in front of me. So I feel that I'm addressing a multicultural audience or a multilinguistic audience. It's something which is very rare of its kind. You know, probably if I happen to visit some place in Karnataka, Kannada gottirbeku. You must know Kannada. Kannada illadre huttidre Kannada nadil huttirbeku. So now most of you who understood what I said, you enjoyed, but most of them who did not understand what I said, they missed the point. So this is a multicultural, multilinguistic. What I said was that huttidre Kannada nadil huttirbeku, meaning, oh, you have a lot of Kannada. Meaning, if you're born, you should be born in the Kannada lands. It's a very famous statement made by a very famous actor in Karnataka, Dr. Rajkumar, whom a lot of people, they adore him, they revere him. And, you know, if you happen to go to Tamil Nadu, if you go into Tamil Nadu, they will say, Poranda Tamil Mandalam Porakano. Do you have any Tamilian out here? You don't have Tamilian? Nobody here? Okay, what it means is that if you are born, you should be born in Tamil Nadu. So every land, they have their own, you know, they feel very good about it. It's fine too, as long as we have that very positive nature, the very positive attitude that you love your motherland is something good. You can love your motherland. You can be sincere to it, but do not consider others with contempt. Do not look at others by debasing attitude, like looking at them and you like demeaning them just because of their ethnicity. Don't go to the extent of looking them down, just because of their ethnicity. That is one of the major problems of moral development. One of the major problems is to generalize people based on where they come from or you are from Sri Lanka, then you are an LTT. You know, that's a kind of a generalization. You know, we need to refrain from these kind of attitude and look at the goal. We need to set a goal. What are we here for? What are we here for? Education. Education, like the gentleman rightly put across. He said, in school days, we've been educated. Be good. Don't cheat. Don't tell lies. Excellent. Excellent. All these things, wonderful words. But you happen to go out of school and college, you see something else. You'll be going in your two-wheeler, immediately you'll find a man. Stop, 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 fine. Like, why? No, you were just crossing the signal without the instruction. You're not supposed to go that way. You skip the signal. I said, no, I just moved in green signal. No, no, no. Okay, what is it? 200 rupees, fine. 50 rupees, I'll let you go. 50 rupees, I'll let you go. So now what's happening is, now we learned a lot of things. Now you can't speak all this law on the street. It doesn't work there. Why it doesn't work there? Because no one is good here. No one is good. When I say no one is good, maybe one of you may just think, no, I'm good here, I'm good here. But collectively, when we are on the street, somebody is speaking for something rightful, somebody is speaking for justice, are we there to support him on this cause? Are we there to voice out for him? Somebody is saying, no, I did not skip the signal. Are we there to say, yes, he did not skip the signal. Come on, you can't pull him. Come on, you can't find him. Can we say that? If we say that, that means we have reached the level of moral, ethical value. If you don't say that, that means all these things are there in the books. Very well printed, excellent, excellent. Everything is beautiful, very well drafted, with beautiful fonts, but doesn't make sense. So one of the most things that I want to start with for moral degradation is to demean people without any just cause. Just because he's a North Indian, the South Indian cannot go on dragging him. Just because he's a South Indian, in North India you can't drag him. I've seen the college life. I know what it is. I know in my college days, there was this man who happened to be a very good ranked student from North India. Very good ranked student from North India. And he happened to come as a junior. And you know what the people they do, the senior boys. They ragged him so much that he became a psychopath. He became a psychopath and all his life went into drain. You know, these are the things which are the hard realities. We think that it's just dragging. I was just watching through the board when I was walking down. You know, don't drag in this campus. And I was just posing the question, can we drag outside the campus? So you should not drag within the campus, but outside you can drag. So that's what it is. Or rather, why do they say don't drag? Doesn't mean that, you know, ragging, you know, it's not just that they don't want to, they want to stop you having fun. I know it is fun, you know, making fun of people. People laugh for a while, they enjoy it for a while. But you must see from the other end, how does he feel humiliated? Would you like to be in this situation? Would you like to? But how would we expect a generation which comes out through this kind of a culture? What kind of a generation are we building up in the future for the future generation out of this culture? Can you do all of these things in the office place? Now, these people who get groomed in ragging and all these things, when they come out as the Chief Justice of Karnataka, or when they come out as the DCP or ACP and all of these things, they still have the remnants of what they learned in the schools and colleges. And that's the reason you have ethical, moral degradation. It's nothing strange. What we culture in the schools, you get to harvest. What you culture is what you harvest. What you sow is what you reap. It's nothing new. But how far are we going to keep this? So let me tell you, I've read a lot of scriptures from various religious backgrounds, like the Bible, the Vedas, the Upanishads, and the Quran. And you can see me by my logo that I'm a Muslim who happen to respect all the prophets. No, there is a great place in my heart for Jesus Christ. May peace be upon him. The Quran says, a person who does not believe in Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him, he is not a Muslim. So as far as me, as far as you can take me, I'm a person who respect all the prophets, be it Jesus, Moses, David, Solomon, or Abraham, Noah, Adam, and all of them. And I love all the prophets, including the last and the final prophet, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And all the scriptures, they aim towards spiritual development. All the scriptures want you to become a better human. If I ask a question, who is the best man? Who is the best man? I just said, Huttidre, Kannadanadil Huttirbeku. Is the Kannadiga good man? Or if I say the best man is a Tamilian? Or is the best man a Kashmiri? I see a lot of Kashmiris. Or is the best man American? Indian? Who is the best man? Again, a good human being. And who can be a good human being? A man who is God conscious. If you're conscious enough, when you're doing any deed, you ask yourself, you introspect yourself, am I doing something which is accountable? Am I doing something which is noteworthy, which is valuable, which is beneficial? Am I doing something which is pleased by God Almighty? Is it a deed which is something which God accepts? Then you are a good man. We don't need the logo. Are you a person who is accountable in this life? Yes, I'm a teacher. What am I here for? I'm a teacher. What am I here for? I want to build and nurture a beautiful generation. That's my purpose to be here. Not to fill my pockets. Why am I here as a student? Not to become a person who can earn a lot of money and money. That is not the purpose. So that I can be the beacon to the next generation. So that I can be a lighthouse for the next generation. I can be one amongst the torchbearers for the next generation. I got to be amongst the change. I will be part of the change. Can you be that? So who is the best man? Okay, let me just ask you one simple question. Yes, brother there. What do you want to be after finishing this course? You want to become an entrepreneur? What do you want to be? One of you, any field of interest, a pharmacist, you want to get into pharmacy, build up a big research and development center, and then do something. What do you want to be, brother? You can say. Businessman. Okay, we don't have anybody apart from the management students, or else some of you might have said, if at all there was someone else, they could have said, I want to become a doctor, or somebody would say, I want to become an engineer. A lot of other questions, but here I think a lot of people would say, businessman. Is there anything else you can say? A good human being. Do you have really that intention, sister? If you really have this intention, then you can fare well in the world. Probably some of them may say, this guy is a fool. He's talking about nonsense. It's not going to work. You know, somebody may think in his own heart, come on, these are the things which are there, but do you think this is going to happen? I've seen the world in my little span of time. I'm now 33 years. I happen to go to the court of Bangalore. There's a judge there. I was listening to him just to hear some verdict. And I happened to cross through and just behind with the clerk, he's asking for 50 bucks. Where? It's all in the broad daylight. It's not happening in dark, my dear. It's happening in broad daylight. I know a lot of people may think, how can it happen? Yes, it is difficult. But don't you want to be part of the change? Don't you want to change the system for a better tomorrow? For our children to enjoy? Yes, all these days, I don't think it is possible. You may think, but that is a negative attitude. With negative attitude, you can never become a businessman. Can you become a businessman? Let me tell you an example. Probably you are all management students. You'll have more idea.